In the 1600s, Mintinacock Native Americans traded the peninsular land to James Lloyd, an English settler from Oyster Bay. The area was in turn called Lloyd Neck. The village that was subsequently established was still occupied by the British during the Revolutionary War. The British ships docked in the harbor and, while protecting Lloyd Neck, would use the large boulder for target practice, and hence the name Target Rock. Now fast forward to the man who donated the refuge land. Who was Ferdinand Eberstadt anyway? Well, he attended Princeton University and then served in World War I. Upon his return, he rose to prominence in the 1920s as a lawyer turned investment banker and later a trusted policy advisor to the U.S. government. While he lived and worked in New York City, his financial success enabled him to purchase 80 acres of land on the Lloyd Harbor Peninsula of Long Island. His new estate would be called Target Rock Farm, as it was previously called. This is a misleading name because the Eberstadts didn't maintain a farm at all. Instead, the land was transformed into beautifully landscaped gardens with its very own greenhouse.